All right, Michael, I think it's a mistake for conservatives to portray Bloomberg's comments as merely sucking up to California voters. I don't think that that's all he's doing. Perhaps that plays a part in it, but I think he is revealing the strategy of the left. They look at California and they like what they see. They want California policies across the entire nation.
Absolutely. It's a natural fit for Mike Bloomberg to admire California, because Mike Bloomberg, for his whole life, has been pretty removed from the regular old people walking down on the street. This was true when he was mayor. This is true today. He's not a classic retail politician because he doesn't like being around people. So he's not seeing the effect of these policies on the ground. And I live in Los Angeles. I can tell you that the effect of these policies have been awful. The government of California has been wrong on virtually every single issue, and the state is really falling apart all around us. I see it every single day. But what Mike Bloomberg would admire about a state like California is how successful it has been at taking power away from the regular old people walking around on the street and taking that power for itself. That's the one common thread in Mike Bloomberg's governance. I actually lived in New York when Mike Bloomberg was mayor, and I'm not saying he was the worst mayor in the history of New York, but the thing he kept doing time and time again was taking more and more power for the government. You saw this when he tried to ban big cups of soda. You saw this when he banned people from smoking cigarettes, not just indoors, but even outside on the street or in parks. He was a nanny state governor, and the government of California has done a great job at increasing the size of that nanny state. Trouble is, it's ruined the conditions for those of us who have to live in it.